Hi, welcome to the first episode of a series of videos on doing creative things with sound and music in the web browser using p5.js.
p5.js is a JavaScript library for creative coding. It's a web-oriented interpretation of processing, which is a Java-based language for learning how to code by creating sketches in the context of visual art and design. The language of the web browser is JavaScript. p5.js is a JavaScript library, which means it's a collection of pre-written computer code you can use in your JavaScript programs. There are basically two ways you can create sketches with p5.js. You can either use the online editor, or you can set up a development environment on your computer using a code editor. In this series of videos, I'll be taking the second approach, using the free Visual Studio Code. There is a guide to both approaches on the P5 website, which also includes information about setting up a local server in combination with a code editor. Setting up a local server lets you run your code in a browser and have the browser update anytime you make and save any changes in your code editor. So, to run p5.js locally, I first download and unzip a copy of the complete p5.js library and then open up Visual Studio Code. Next, I drag the p5 folder onto the main editor window. The folder and its contents are now listed in the Explorer panel. There are two folders, Add-ons and Empty Example, two JavaScript files, p5.js and p5.min.js, and a README file. The README tells me about each of the files in the complete library download. The two p5.js files provide the complete p5 library in two versions. One of these has the extension .min.js. This is a minified version of the library that is optimized to save file space. The add-ons folder includes the p5.sound files, which adds web audio functionality to p5. Let's focus on the folder called Empty Example. The index.html file provides some pre-written code which displays and styles your P5 sketch in a browser window. Notice that the script tag on line 16 is commented out. You'll need to uncomment that if you want to use the sound functionality in your sketch. We do that by removing the comment marks and the code changes color to show that it is now active. Notice that the HTML code gives relative paths for the location of the P5 JavaScript library files. This means they specify the location of the file starting from the current directory location. The double dot means the directory above the current directory. Finally, we come to the sketch.js file itself, which is where we will write our JavaScript code. Let's check everything is working by writing a few test lines. Let's say I'll create a canvas with dimensions 800 by 600 pixels. A canvas is a designated area of the browser where your P5 sketch will be rendered. I'll give it a mid-blue background using RGB color values. Red equals 0, green equals 0, and blue equals 125. To see this in the browser, I need to open the index.html file. I've previously installed a live server extension, so I can click on the index.html tab and then click Go Live in the blue status bar. Now, every time I make a change in my code and save it, the browser will update automatically.
In the next video, we'll see how to play a sound in the browser window. We'll also see how to write an algorithm that divides a program into small steps and how it can be useful to write those steps out in plain language before we write any computer code. So please subscribe to this channel and I'll see you in the next episode.